flow through venturimeter. The aim of the experiment is to determine the coefficient of discharge for liquid flowing through venturimeter. The apparatus required for this experiment is venturimeter, piping system, measuring tank, sump tank, differential manometer, and a supply pump set. Venturimeter is used to find the discharge of fluid flowing through a pipe. It consists of a short converging part and a long diverging part, which is being connected by a throat. This apparatus shows a venturimeter connected to a pipe. Two sections, one is at the throat and another one is at the converging part of the venturimeter, are connected to a U-tube manometer to find out the pressure difference between these two sections. Procedure: close all the ball valves in the pipes except the ball valves which are connected to the manometer. And before starting the experiment, the pipe manometer has to be primed properly. Priming is nothing but filling the manometer with the water so as to remove the air from the pipes. Then open the inlet gate valve, adjust the control valve which is kept at the exit, and the flow rate should be maintained steadily. Note down the time required for 10 cm rise in the measuring tank and take down the manometer reading. We have to continue this for different flow rates. Actual discharge can be calculated by this formula: AH divided by T, where A is the area of the measuring tank in meter squared, H is the difference in levels of water in meter into 13.6 minus 1, and T is the time in seconds. Theoretical discharge can be calculated by the formula: A1 A2 root 2 GH divided by root of A1 squared minus A2 squared. The coefficient of discharge can be calculated by dividing actual discharge by theoretical discharge. These are the observed values. The diameter of inlet is observed as 0.025 meters. Diameter of the throat of the venturimeter is observed as 0.0145 meters. And the length, breadth and area of the tank is also observed. In tabular column, we have to take the manometer readings H1 and H2. We have to find the difference in H1 and H2 readings. We have to take the root H value. The time taken for 10 cm rise of water has to be noted down. From these readings, we can calculate the actual discharge and the theoretical discharge. And the coefficient of discharge CD can be calculated by dividing actual discharge by theoretical discharge. Actual discharge can be calculated by the formula AH by T, and the theoretical discharge can be calculated by the formula A1 A2 root 2 GH by root of A1 squared minus A2 squared. And the coefficient of discharge value is being calculated as 0.661. The mean coefficient of discharge of the venturimeter is calculated as 0.928.